3, 2, 1. Hello to the nation, Nick here. Tonight you guys are for a little bit of a snapshot spotlight. Hopefully you guys are having a great day. Today we're going to be talking about the new Minecraft 1.9 snapshot that's released. It's August 1st, so there is not a ton known, but there is quite enough for me to make a little overview for you guys. Today we're going to be just going generally over all of the stuff. If you guys want, you guys can click that little eye on the top right hand corner of the screen, and hopefully there'll be a playlist there with all my 1.9 videos showing you guys all the various things and going fully in depth. Today I just want to show you guys a short, concise little overview as to what we're hoping to see in Minecraft 1.9 and all that cool stuff. But anyway, let's get started. So first of all, one of the most anticipated things is actually dual wield mode. So dual wield mode, you guys will notice that when you spawn in, nothing really different is going to change. I'm pretty much going to turn off music because that's quite annoying, but nothing really different is going to happen. It's not going to look very different, but if you guys go over to your inventory, you guys will see that there's this little shield slot here, and if you guys hit F while holding an item, it will go into your left hand. Now you guys can change this by going into your options and going into your skin customization and changing your main hand from left to right. You guys can do that. Right would be the default main hand. And then from there, you guys can use your F key to swap hands with anything that you're holding in your hand, including nothing. So you guys can swap it in and out of your main hand. So anyway, with that being said, what can you do with dual wield mode? So most people were anticipating something along the lines of you being able to hold a bow in this hand and you can break dirt and use your bow at the same time. That's not really what you can do. Your main hand is the only hand that can actually interact with the world in the way of breaking things. So if you want to break a block or use an axe on wood or a shovel on dirt, you can only do that or in order to collect the blocks with your right hand. If you want to hurt something like a cow or something with a sword or a bow, you can only do that with your main hand. Now what you can do is I have this shovel in my hand, and if I have nothing in my other hand, I can actually use it to till, this isn't a hoe, so it wouldn't be tilling, and I'm using this to turn it into a path, which is a new 1.9 block, so that's kind of cool. I really do like that sort of aspect of it. You can swap it and still do the same thing with the right click, but it's nice to see that it's there. In addition to that, you guys can use it to do things like, you know, place torches that are in your hand without having it open, you can hold other things at the same time, and you can still punch like so, which is quite interesting. So those sort of aspects are pretty cool, and that's basically how dual wield mode is. I can go more depth into that in a future video, but pretty much that's what we know about dual wield mode right now, or dual wielding weapons, I should say. The next thing that is really changing is the arrows. So there is actually a ton of various arrows. If I actually go and type in all the arrows, you guys can see all of them there. I'm going to make its own video for those, but the two main types are effect arrows and spectral arrows. So the effect arrows have various effects, things like strength, resistance, and visibility, night vision, and whatnot, and the spectral arrows are going to do this. So if I actually shoot this mob right here, sadly I messed that one up, and I didn't shoot the spectral arrow. The bow is going to shoot the arrow that is leftmost in your hotbar. So if you guys see, I can shoot that cow, and when I go over here, you guys are going to see that I still see the outline of it for quite some time. In fact, I could be extremely far away from it and still see that outline for several seconds after I've shot it, so you guys can see the effect is gone. But that's what spectral arrows are gonna do. Now, say I wanted to give somebody, you know, in this case I want to give myself night vision, I could use the game mode. I've got to switch myself in game mode, and then I can shoot myself with it. So I'm actually gonna shoot myself with that arrow here, so we're gonna see if I can hit myself with it. Oh, and of course I missed myself. There we go. Boom! And as you guys can see, I got 3 minutes of night vision. The other thing that's kind of cool to see is you guys can see in the hotbar, the animation right now for the bow is kind of cool, so that's definitely something interesting. So that was kind of neat. I definitely do like those little things that they've added, but anyway, I shot my spectral arrow over there, so that's it for the arrows. I will go over those in their own video, but anyway, we are going to grab these guys so we can throw these guys in there. Now, all that's pretty much left is a few more ender items, so end items or end things that we can go over. So I'm actually going to switch into game mode for this one, and I'm going to go ahead and look for a few different items to show you guys. So first of all, let's grab this guy. So this guy is kind of interesting. So you guys actually will have a dragon head that you guys can get. So boom, that's a thing. I'm going to talk more about the dragon and the new battle system in another video, so make sure you guys go and check that out. But we have right here this chorus fruit, popped chorus fruit, purple block, you know, purple pillars. There's also purple slabs and purple stairs, so things like that. So we're going to head into the Nether here. So as you guys can see also, I didn't mention, but the effects now, if you guys see the top right-hand corner, you guys can actually see the effects there and the time that's left on them. So that's kind of an interesting feature. So we're going to quickly go ahead and kill this Ender Dragon so that we can show you guys the other aspect of this that's going to change a little bit. So here we go. There's also going to be ways that you can spawn back in the Ender Dragon. There's also currently a way in the snapshot that I'll show you guys again in another video. The purpose of this video is just to quickly go over all of the things that have changed. Okay, so now, guys, that we have killed the Ender Dragon successfully, we're going to see the same animation that we've seen before, which is pretty cool. You definitely do like it. You know, it's interesting. You see the same XP that you've exploded before. The portal will then appear underneath it. You'll see the egg, all of that cool stuff. But now, in addition to that, you also get one of these guys. So if we actually get an Ender Pearl here, you guys are going to see that, boom, we can take this Ender Pearl and we can throw it into this guy right here. So if we go over here and we actually just throw this in there, wait for it. Oh. Boom, there we go. We actually get to teleport into what is called the End Islands, as I've heard it be referred to. So anyway, in these End Islands, you guys are gonna see things like these. These are chorus plants. These chorus plants, just like cactus, they're gravity affected, and if you break the bottom block, they will all sort of fall down, and they're gonna give you these things called chorus fruit. Now, if you cook these up in a furnace, they're gonna give you the popped chorus, and the popped chorus fruit you can actually use to combine into the purple blocks, purple pillars. Purple blocks can then be combined into other things like stairs and slabs and whatnot. You guys can actually use these too. You can't actually plant these, as you guys can see, but if you do go up here and you actually break these guys with a proper item, you guys are going to be able to get these coarse flowers and be able to plant those yourself on endstone. You can even plant those on endstone in the normal world, in the normal overworld, so that's kind of cool. Over here, we're going to see our first end city. So the end cities are really cool. They're going to have a new mob in them called the Shulker. Shulker, yes, Shulker. So these are going to be made out of the blocks that we talked about earlier, so you guys can use these to harvest all your slabs, your pulper slabs, and all that stuff. But they're also going to be guarded by these Shulkers. So you guys can see these guys here are going to pop in and out, and if we actually go and switch out of game mode, they're going to start shooting us, and they're going to shoot us with these little things here. So if I actually get them to see me, see, they're going to shoot these little things here, and what those are actually going to do is if they hit me, they're going to give me a... Come on, there we go. They're gonna give me what's called a levitation effect for 10 seconds, and you actually can't control it. You're gonna be constantly levitating and whatnot. Now, when I lose this effect, I'm going to pretty much just fall, and if I was not in game mode, I would actually take damage, which would hurt me, so that'd be quite bad. So they can be quite dangerous, but they can also be helpful, because as you guys are going to see in here, there is quite the odd scene of parkour that you need to do to get from top to bottom. And as we go over here, you guys are going to see that they're going to play even more of a role. So at these entrances here, if you got hit by a Shulker, you guys could take the damage hit, but it'll help you get all the way to the top. These things can be pretty difficult to sort of make your way through, but they're going to have increasingly better and better loot. So this one has 6 gold and a silk touch shovel. You guys can then continue up from here, and at the very top there's going to be some additional chests that you guys can harvest from. So here we go, boom, we got several diamonds here, we got, you know, some iron, some more iron, and unbreaking 3, prot 4, thorns 2 chest plate, which is pretty fracking awesome. And then you get up to the top here and you guys can do anything you really want here, so that's quite cool. Definitely do like it. You guys get access to these banners and whatnot, so it's definitely a really cool thing. So you guys can explore, you know, these end islands and kind of see what there is to see, explore all these cities. They're somewhat common, at least, because that was like right next to where we spawned in. And then from there, you guys would have to go back to where you spawned, throw an Ender Pearl to get back to where you were in the end, and then jump through the portal to get back there. That's from my understanding how you guys are going to get out of here. So it is quite the difficult thing to sort of, you know, get through and get back to your overworld base and whatnot, but it is definitely a cool adventure to make. But anyway, guys, without further ado, that's kind of the end. I did miss 2 things that I wanted to mention, and that was these guys here, the end rod. These end rods are pretty much just like torches. So pretty much just like torches, they'll light up an area around it. You guys don't necessarily notice now because I have my gamma cranked, but they will light an area up just like a torch does. And the benefit of them is you get to place them sideways too. So these are going to be great for parkour. Minecraft 1.9 parkour maps are going to be absolutely crazy because, you know, these are pretty much like fence posts but sideways, and they also light up an area, which is kind of cool. So that's pretty much what we're going to be seeing. And the other thing that I forgot to mention too much about is the beats. So the beats by Dre are now in Minecraft. No, I'm just kidding. But these are beet roots, and you can eat them. You can also turn them into beet soup, and those are going to enhance six sticks, so three full hunger sticks. Not necessarily the greatest thing, but they should be, you know, introduced as other things maybe. We'll start seeing them in other things. But anyway, hopefully you guys did enjoy. Make sure you guys slam that like button down below. Comment down below anything that you're excited about for Minecraft 1.9. And make sure you guys check out any of my other videos on Minecraft 1.9. Click that little eye on the top right-hand corner, and you guys will be able to go and check out any of my other videos that I've made talking about Minecraft 1.9. And if there isn't any, make sure you guys hit that subscribe button, and there will be soon. So anyway, hopefully you guys did enjoy. I'm the Doctor, and I'm out. Bye.